case, this average case you have seen, why we are doing this, because we want to detect a collision. Okay, so for collision detection, I have already told you that I want my TT should be greater than TP, because I want because if I get back the collision signal, I should be transmitting. Only then the workstation or I know that my packet that I've sent is included or is included in the collision or has participated in the collision. Okay, so in this particular case, this is the average case you have seen here. In this average case, you have seen after if you send the signal here, it will get in the collision. It will get in the collision after 30 minutes, and you will get back the collision in 30 minutes. So total 1 hour, you will get a collision signal. Okay, so I can say that this is just an average case. But if I take the worst case, now in worst case, what can happen? Okay, so suppose this is your worst case. Just wait a second. Yeah, okay, so this is your worst case. Now in this worst case, what can happen? Suppose at I'll take any time you can to demonstrate this example. So I'm taking a time. Okay, so suppose at 11, so I'll write it as well, okay, so that you can easily understand this one. So at 11, A and B started transmitting. Okay, so they have detected that they have sensed the courier and seen that there is that at 11 a.m. A sensed the courier and started the transmission. Okay, so it is transmitting. Now suppose, because you already know TP take 1 hour, TP take 1 hour, this is the maximum time to reach to this particular workstation, that is B, and at exact 11:59:59, okay, so at 11:59:59, B sends the courier and found that this courier is empty, and this particular workstation started to transmit its signal. Okay, so now B started to transmit its signal. At now what will happen? B transmitted. Okay, so at 11, A transmitted at 11:59:59:59. It means at the very close to 12 hour. That is the packet is very close to reach to the destination. Then B started transmitted. Okay, so when B started transmitted at exactly 12, there is a collision. Okay, there is a collision. Exactly, there will be a collision. So collision signal get back to B at the same instance. Okay, so it can be because it is just have put the packet onto the link. At that time, the collision is just the signal is just reaches back to B, and it knows by packet is included in the collision. But see, from this A side, how much time? This is the worst case. Now find how much time does it take to get back the signal. Okay, so now it has taken around 1 hour, 1:59:59, to reach this particular end. It means if I started the signal at 11:59, its signal was supposed to reach, but at 12 it got collided with another signal. Okay, and when does the collision signal will be received back to it? It will again take 1 hour more to get back this collision signal. So at 1, A will get the collision signal. Okay, now see this particular time. Okay, so now this is the worst case. Now worst case, the collision happened here. It means it take 1 hour for A to transmit or for propagation of the signal, and another 1 hour to get the collision signal back, okay, so I can say collision signal back. Okay, so in order to guarantee that I should be able to detect the collision signal, my TT my TT, the time that I reach, the time that I got back the collision signal, I should be transmitting, okay? So that is why I've said my TT should be greater than or equal to what, how many hours? 2 hours here, okay? So it, I can say 2 into TP, okay? So whatever is the whatever is the round trip time or 2 into TP time, I have the, my TT should be greater than or equal to that time, okay? So it means this is the worst case now, okay? So after 2 hours, after sending the signal, after sending the signal at 11, after 2 hours at 1, I will get a collision signal back, okay? So this is the worst case you can find, okay? So that is why I've said that my TT, when I got back the signal at 1, I should be transmitting so that I know my packet is involved in a collision. So that is the main underlying concept here. So that is why by this condition, you can say TT is greater than equal to 2 into TP. Okay, so this is the condition that transmission delay should be greater than or equal to 2 into the propagation delay. Okay, so now this is the main, if you have understand this particular thing, I think you easily understand everything. Okay, so if I take one example to make you understand, so I can say that my TP is 1 millisecond, my bandwidth is suppose 2 megabytes per second, okay, something like that. Okay, you can take 1 megabyte per second if you want. So I can ask you that what is the minimum amount of okay, so I before telling you this, I have to also tell you the length of the packet. Okay, so let me see. Yeah, okay, so the length of the packet is also good. Okay, so according to the condition, each station must transmit the data packet of size whose transmission delay is at least twice its propagation delay. Okay, so if the size of the packet is smaller, then the collision detection would not be possible. Okay, so actually if you are seeing here, I can also find out that what should be my length of the packet such that I have to know in CSM ACD. Okay, so what is the length of the packet? You can find it out because it is a transmission delay. So you can say length over bandwidth, it is greater than equal to 2 into propagation delay. Okay, so what should be the length of the packet so that you should know that that my transmission time will be, okay? So what is the meaning of it? I'll tell you, just wait for a second. So my length of the packet should be 2 into TP into bandwidth, okay? So from this particular statement, you understand that my transmission or my TT should be greater than or equal to 2 into TP because when I get back the collision signal, I should be transmitting, okay? So for transmission, I have to know what will be my size of the packet, okay? So if I know the size of the packet, I will know that this size packet will take this much amount of time, okay? So now what is the size of the packet? So size of the packet, you can easily find it by length over bandwidth, okay? So the length of the packet or the size of the packet should be greater than equal to 2 into TP into bandwidth, okay? So that you can easily find out. If I take any example, you can easily find out, okay? So that is also given there. And if I just take an example, so I can say that what should be my length of the packet? What is the length of the packet in CSM ACD? Okay, so you can be asked like this question, what is the length of the packet in CSM ACD? Okay, so you already know length of the packet should be L should be greater than equal to 2 into bandwidth into TP. Okay, so TP I have already given you. So length should be equal to 2 into what is the bandwidth? It is 1 Mbps, and what is TP here? 20 M millisecond. Okay, so if you just extract it out, 1 Mbps means 1 × 10⁻⁶ bits per second. BPS, and what is 1 millisecond? 1 × 10⁻³⁻³. Okay, 1 × 10⁻³⁾ seconds. Okay, so now if you can find it out, it will be 2 into. I think it can be 10⁻³ here. Okay, so 10⁻³ because we are finding it in length, it can be bits. Okay, so it means that it will be 2000 bits. Okay, so it means your length of the packet should be 2000 bits if you want to detect the collision signal. Okay, so if you want to detect the collision signal, your length of the packet, given that your TP is 1 millisecond and bandwidth is 1 Mbps, should be 2000 bits. Okay, so again, you will be thinking that it is a compulsion. If you do not have 2000 bits to transmit, suppose you have only 1000 bits. Okay, so if you have only 1000 bits, you have to add a padding of extra 1000 bit. Okay, so if you have 1000 bits, you have to add 1000 extra bit for this condition to be correct. Okay, so you have to add extra 1000 bit. This 1000 extra bit are called padding. Okay, so they are dummy bits. The padding bits are dummy bits. I think I've already told you about this one. Okay, so in CSMS CD you cannot transmit 1000 bit because if your packet is involved in a collision, you will not get to know about it. So that is why you have to add extra 1000 bits. Okay, so that can also happen. Keep that this concept in mind. Okay, so with this I have to find the efficiency. So if you get there, just wait a second. Okay, so how can you find the efficiency? So efficiency in case of CSMS CD is given as, so I'll tell you, it is 1 over 1 plus 6.4 over A. Okay, so this is the efficiency that is given in your CSMS CD. It is not given in there. So I think if you are thinking how I got to this particular step here, so before it, you already know, if you want to find a CSMS CD, how can I find the efficiency of CSMS CD? Okay, so now what is the efficiency of CSMS CD? Okay, so I'll talk about efficiency of CSMS CD. It is also referred to as Ethernet. Keep in mind, sometimes they used what is the efficiency of Ethernet, but actually they are asking what is the efficiency of CSMS CD here. Okay, so now if you take a look about it, how can I find the efficiency? You already know efficiency is useful time over cycle time. Okay, cycle time or total time. Okay, so now what exactly be the useful time here? You already know your useful time. Most probably it will be your TT. And what exactly be the total time here? So that is the main question here. Okay, so suppose, because you already know that in CSMS CD, this is possible that you will not get a successful communication in the first go. Okay, so it can happen. So suppose if you do not get a successful communication, 2 into TP time will be wasted. Okay, so for unsuccessful one. Okay, so for A, you transmitted some packets. For B also transmitted packet. So 2 into TP is the maximum amount of time that is required to detect the collision signal. Okay, so if the communication is successful, this much amount of time you have to wait. Again, after some time you have transmitted the packet, and again the packet is unsuccessful. Suppose it is unsuccessful, then again 2 into TP time will be required. Again 2 into TP time will be required for an unsuccessful attempt. After that, again you have transmitted after some time and you again got a collision. So again you have to wait for 2 into TP amount of time. Okay, so this is your unsuccessful events. Okay, so if you got successful, suppose if you got successful, in the successful attempt you only require your TT amount of time to put the packet onto the link, plus your TP, that the propagation. Okay, so if your attempt is successful, it means that there is no collision between any workstation. It means that you are successful. It means for that, for the successful attempt, you only require this much amount of time. This much amount of time means you have to put the packet onto the link and the packet should successfully propagate towards the destination. Okay. So when there is an unsuccessful attempt, you have to wait for this much amount of time. If the if your attempt is successful, again you only require this much amount of time. Okay. So again, after that there will be some unsuccessful attempts. After that there will be some successful attempt. Like again, it will require TT plus T. Okay. So when you try to find out the efficiency of this, it will be given as what is the useful time, useful work that you are doing here? Also, it is TT here. Okay, so you already know, because the station can only do this much useful time, because in TP, the station does not participate. When station only participate in putting the packet onto the link or putting the bits onto the link. After that, the bits are going as it is. They are already going by some velocity. In this particular task, the station is not participating. The propagation part, station is not participating, but in the transmission part, the station is participating. So useful work for the station will be this. And now see the total time. Suppose this is your you got these many unsuccessful attempt to get a successful communication. So I'm taking this particular cycle here. Okay, this is your in this particular time, what I have done, what useful work I have done, this is TT, and what is the total time here. Okay, so if you find the total time here for a successful attempt, it is TT plus TP. You already know this. For unsuccessful, there may be unsuccessful attempts as well. So there are three collisions here. Okay, so I can say 3 into 2 into TP. Okay, so if I generalize it, it can become TT over. Now this 3, I can call this as C into 2 into TP plus TT plus TP. Okay, so now this is your collisions, number of collisions. So number of collisions. So from this, if you equate, there are many ways to equate it from here. Actually, this is the efficiency of your CSMACD. But it is further simplified. Okay, so the efficiency of CSMACD is further simplified, and the answer that is given in your books or in your any other internet source is 1.6.44. Okay, so this is the efficiency of your CSMACD. Okay, so if you want to go in detail, because we have the number of collisions here. Okay, so you have to give how many number of collisions will be there for after how many number of collisions should be there before a successful transmission. Okay, so you have to find it out. If you find it out and find the value of C, it can be simplified to this 1.644a. Okay, so for calculations of this, for calculations from this to this, there are three concepts required. First one is binomial distribution, and another one is your Poisson distribution. Two concepts that is needed here. Okay, so there is no need to go into the derivation of this formula. So you can remember that it is 1 over 1 plus 6.44a. But still, if you want to refer to the calculation, so you can go towards this link. Okay, so this is Geeks for Geeks link. So if you want to refer to the calculations, I think I have opened it. Okay, so this is the calculation that is going on in the calculation of efficiency of CSMACD. Okay, so there is something given as contention slot. Okay, so contention slot is nothing, it is a collision slot. Okay, so it is sometimes referred to as contention or collision. Okay, so again, if you are seeing here, it is based on the concept of probability. Okay, so this is using binomial distribution. From this, they are easily able to find out one by. Okay, so I'll give you a little bit of introduction that how can you get to this. Okay, so the main question is I have to find the number of collisions. Okay, so find the number of collisions, that is number of C's here. Okay, so this particular thing. Okay, so if you are able to find the number of collisions, you have to put the value here and again calculate the efficiency for CSMACD. Okay, so again, to calculate this, we need another concept as probability. So probability, in probability, before going to the probability, you have to know that what exactly is successful transmission. Okay, So successful transmission is when one station transmit and others are not transmitting. Okay, so when one station transmits, others are refraining from transmitting. Okay, so others refrain. And so I call this as a successful transmission, because it means that one station is transmitting, no other station is transmitting, so the communication will be successful. Okay, so I'll say that probability for success, now I have to find the probability of success, that when will this particular scenario, or when then this particular event happens. Okay, so probability of success is what is the probability of success? It's the probability of success is when only one station is transmitting. Okay, so I'm giving it as P success. P success is given by out of n station, one station is transmitting with a probability P. Out of n station, one station is transmitting with a probability P, and n minus one stations are not transmitting. Okay, so 1 minus P means they are not transmitting. So this is your binomial distribution also. You can refer to this particular thing. So that is given as, this is the P success probability, that is NC1 into P into 1 minus P into N minus 1. So it actually means is that out of N station, one station is transmitting with the probability P, and other stations are not transmitting with the probability 1 minus P. Okay, so this is the probability of transmitting, and this is the probability of not transmitting. Okay, so whatever is the probability of transmitting, it will be 1 minus something. Okay, so 1 minus P. Suppose the probability of transmitting is 0.80. So what is the probability of not transmitting? It will be 1 minus 0.80. It will be 0.20. Okay, so in a similar way, if you want to find out the maximum value of this P success, okay, so in order to find the maximum value of P success, you have to differentiate it. Okay, so this is again core mathematics here. If you want to find out the maximum value of P success, you have to differentiate it with dP success over P. Okay, so this is your P equal to zero. Okay, so again, you have to differentiate it two times after you get the answer. The value should be less than zero, so there is no need to calculate it. You can find it yourself. The value of P from this particular equation will be 1 by L. Okay, so it means that P, when P is 1 by M, the probability of success is maximum. Okay, so again, if you put the value of P here, you will find out the probability of maximum success. Maximum success. Okay, so it should be NC1 into what is the value of P here now, 1 by N, and it is 1 over 1 minus N and N minus 1. Okay, so if you solve it, you will find that it is 1 over 1 minus N over N minus 1. Okay, so I'm not solving it because it is not that much important, because I only am concerned with this formula, not this particular calculation. Suppose again, if you find the maximum probability, I think in your this one, I think it is not given here. So they are directly going towards it. Okay, so the success probability, actually they have from this maximum success probability. Now I can say that if I increase the number of station, okay, so probability of maximum success depends upon the number of stations, because N is the number of stations here. Okay, so N is the number of stations. So if I increase the number of stations to infinity, so if I put that there are many number of stations, okay, there are many number of stations, so I have to use limited continuity for this one. So that will be limit of N tends to infinity, where P of success. Okay, so again, if you solve it, P of max success. Okay, so again, if you solve it, you will find that you will get the probability of success as 1 by E. Okay, so they have come there. Okay, so P of max is, this is again Poisson distribution. So they have skipped some steps, I think. Okay, so from this one, it means this is the probability of success here that you find here. That is the probability of maximum success. Okay, so if you want to find out that how many tries should I try, how many times should I try before I get my first success. Okay, so I'll say if 1 by E is the probability of success. So I'll write it, probability of success. Then how many times should I try before I get my first success? Before I get the first success. Okay, so this question is asked in the form of Poisson distribution. Okay, so you can refer to Poisson distribution as well. So this is the same question that is asked in Poisson distribution. So you can solve it by saying that this is 1 over what actually is the probability of max success. Okay, so what is the probability of max success? It is 1 over 1 by E. Okay, so you will find that E, okay, so it is, E is the number of collision before a successful transmission. Okay, so this is E is the number of collision, if it is the number of collision before the successful transmission. So this is your the number, the collision value here. Okay, so now what you do, you put the value of C. We are finding the value of C here because how does it started? Because I have to find the number of collisions. Okay, so number of collisions means how many number of collisions are there before a successful transmission. So this answer is given by Poisson distribution. So again, if you put the value of efficiency here, the efficiency will be TT over C into 2TP into plus TT plus TP. After that, you have to put the value of C here. It is TT over E into 2TP plus TT plus TP. Okay. So after that, you can solve it. Okay. So after that, put the value of E. I think it will be 2.32 because it is a value of exponential. Okay. So you can look at here, the calculation here. You can put the value of C as E and you can put the value of E is 2.72. Okay. So you can equate it, the answer will be 1 over 1 plus 6.44 E. okay, so I am directly writing the answer is 1 over 1 plus 6.44 E. okay, so where A is again TP by TT, you already know that. Okay, so for this particular question, you do not have to remember this, or you have do not have to do this much calculations, because I am only concerned with this formula. Okay, so still, if you want to find out that how this particular formula is calculated, I have given you some rough steps. I have given you some explanation to this. If you do not know the concept of binomial distribution, you can look for it on internet and you can try to solve it. Okay, so I've given you intermediate steps. There is no much, because if you look at the formula, I'm directly putting the values of formula here. Okay, so for Poisson distribution also, I'm directly putting the value that what actually is the whatever is the formula of Poisson distribution, I'm directly putting the value here. In the similar way, you can also solve from this. Okay, so if I just prefer that you just remember this particular thing. So I always tell you to do not remember anything, but in this particular case, I'm telling you to just remember this particular formula, rather than remembering all the mathematics behind it. Okay, so because you cannot derive it in your exam, because there are so much things going on, you have to know Poisson and other things. Okay, so still, I've given you the steps. If you do not want to go in deep that how this particular efficiency formula is calculated, you can refer to these steps. Okay, so every step is one by one, and you can you have to go towards binomial distribution. You have to go with the basic concept of probability, and you have to go the basic concepts of Poisson distribution. After that, you can directly put value. I think I have explained it. Okay, so now from this efficiency, if I put the value of efficiency as efficiency is equal to 1 over 1 plus 6.44 E. Now what is A? It is TP over TT here. Now what is the value of TP over TT? So 1.644 A. What is TP here? TP is your propagation delay, which will depend upon distance over velocity. And what is TT? TT is your transmission delay. It depends upon your length over the bandwidth. Okay. So now if you see it, if you want to see that what actually efficiency depends upon. Okay, so efficiency actually depends upon, if you are seeing here, it is 1 upon D here. So it means that efficiency is inversely proportional to distance. It means if the distance is higher, the efficiency will be lower. If the distance is lower, the efficiency will be higher. Okay, so it means if the distance is less, it means I'm talking about LAN here. So it will be good for LAN. And the packet size, if the distance, the distance is greater, the efficiency will also be lower. Okay, so it means that CSMA/CD will be preferred. That is why it is preferred for LAN, because LAN is less than 10 kilometers. So that is why the distance is less. Again, you can find out another concept like distance inversely proportional to 1/1/L. So it can be directly proportional to L. So it means it is directly proportional. So if the efficiency should be higher, if your length of the packet is big, and the efficiency is less if the length of the packet is small. Okay, so that is why the length of the packet that in this particular CSMA/CD access control method is given as, if you remember, 2 into bandwidth into TP. Okay, so that is why the length is given like this. So because the length of the packet is higher, the efficiency is more, and you can detect the collision as well. Okay, so that is the main concern. So it means that it is good for big packets. Okay, so other things you can easily extract it out, what exactly the meaning of other things. Okay, so now our next access control method is also very important here. So just let me, before going on to the next of algorithm, I have to discuss about the algorithm here, that is your back off algorithm. Okay, so in case of back off algorithm, so I'll open it also. Okay, so for back off algorithm, now why the back off algorithm is invented here, so I'll just write it as I'll go to the slide when I just explain you, because there is some mathematics involved in this. Okay, so it is very simple mathematics. This is just one formula that you have to follow. Okay, so in back off algorithm, why I'm using back off algorithm, suppose when collision occurs between two stations, when collisions occurs between two station, now the collision signal goes back to A and collision signal goes back to B. Okay, so now the question is when to transmit the data, when to retransmit the data. Retransmit means that you have received the signal and you know that your data is corrupted. Now I have to retransmit the data again. So the next question is when to retransmit. Okay, so if the collision between two station, it means that those stations know that we are a part of a collision, so we have to retransmit the packet again. So now with the burning question here is when to retransmit. So this particular thing is decided by back off algorithm. So back off algorithm decides that when should this A and B should retransmit, such that they do not go to the same collision. Okay, so suppose you have called your friend, and what happens is that your call just due to low network, it got cut. Okay, so now what you do, your friend and you, they try to again call you at the same time. Okay, so again, when you when both of them try to call at the same time, there will be again a collision, and you will get a message that the other person is busy, and other person will get the message that you are busy. So you know that you are both calling to each other, that is why the collision is occurring. Again, if you try again after some time, and again your friend also tries at the same time, again you will get a collision, and those will get the same thing. Okay, so after trying two or three times, one person will always wait for some time. Okay, so always one person tries to wait for some time, and then your friend call comes. Okay, so this is the same way here. So if they both started to transmit at the same time, there will be a collision again, and if you both started to retransmit again at the same time, there will be a collision again. Okay, so to solve this problem, we have a back off algorithm. Okay, so I'll take a simple example in this particular case. Now in this particular case, this is the first packet from A station from B station. Okay, so they have transmitted the first packet at the same time. They have transmitted, B has transmitted the first packet. Now there is a collision. Now the collision signal is going back, okay, so collision signal, keep in mind, will be different from the data signal. Okay, so that is how to recognize a collision signal. Okay, so now you this particular packet, that is packet 1 of A, is included in the collision one time. Okay, so I'm writing n equal to 1. This particular packet, that is first packet of B, is included in the collision first time, so I'm writing that the collision number. Okay, so this particular n is your collision number. That number denotes that how many times a particular packet is participated in the collision. Okay, so now you have to select a random number between A and B. Okay, so now what is A for both station? What is A? A will be 0, and what is B here? B is 2^n-1. 2^n-1. Okay, so now check it. 2^ what is n here? It is 1 1 minus 1, so it is 0 2 2 1 1. Okay, 0 to 1 you have to select a number. In the similar way, it is also 0 to 2^n-1, so again it has to select the same number between 0 and 1. Okay, so it cannot be a fractional number, it can either be 0 or 1. Okay, so the possibilities that A and B can select any number will be, suppose this is A and this is B. So A can select 0, B can select 0. A can select 0, B can select 1. A can select 1, B can select 0. And what these are the possible combination between 0, 1 here and 0, 1 here. So A can select 0, at the same time B can select 0. Okay. So now understand this particular thing. 0, 0 means that they are not waiting for any time. Okay, so 0, 0 here means that they are not waiting for any time. They are sending the data at the same time again. So there will be a collision in this particular instance. 0 here means that A will not wait. B will wait for 1 unit time here. Okay, so again there it means that A is successfully able to transmit the data. So it means I say A won here. In the similar case that A will wait for 1 time unit. And B will not wait. In this particular case, B won. Okay. So again, if they selected this scenario, that after both of them are transmitting to the same time, that is after 1 time unit, there will be a collision here again. Okay. So now this, if I say that in this particular case, A's waiting time is given by, because A is waiting for 0 into time slot. Okay. 0 into time slot. And B's waiting time in this particular case is 1 into time slot. Okay, so time slot, you already know time slot is the maximum amount of time that when you are doing sending the packet and there other person is not sending the packet. So time slot, I think we are easily able to find out that it should be greater than equal to 2 into TP. Okay, so time slot, for time slot you can refer to this. So time slot we have already find out, right? Time slot is the maximum amount of time so that you can receive back the collision signal. Okay, so that is why I have to write in the time slot here. Okay, so now in this particular case, suppose I'll show you the drawback of this algorithm. Suppose that A won. Okay, so suppose in this particular, if you find out the probability of winning. Now probability is simple. You can write the favorable outcome over the total outcomes. Okay, so the total outcome here is 4. Now if I want to find out what is the probability of collision. Okay, so what is the probability of collision here? So favorable at two instances there is a collision. So I will write 2/4. What is the probability of A winning, that A is winning 1 out of 4 times. And what is the probability of B is winning 1 out of 4 times. Okay, so the collision probability is 50%. If you see, the probability of winning A is 25% and the probability of winning B is 25%. Okay, so if you are seeing here, the probability of winning A and B is equal and the probability of collision is more here. Okay, so now if you suppose I'm taking a scenario where A win. Okay, so A has won. Now see what happens here. Now suppose at the second time again there is a collision. Now this is the second data packet of A and this is the first data packet of B. Okay, so you already know that this particular packet is not yet transmitted yet. Okay, so A has transmitted, this is the A's new packet. Okay, so when it transmits at the same time, there will be a collision. Now the collision signal will get back to it. Now for this second packet of A, this is the first collision, and for this first packet of B, this is the second collision now. Okay, so if you select the number, the select number will be 0 to 2^n-1, which means it is 0 to 1, But for b here, if you see, but for b here, it will be 2 raised to power 2 minus 1. Okay, so it means that it is 0 to 2 raised to power 2 is 4 minus 1, it is 3. Okay, so now it means that the possible, all possible scenario will be 0, 1, 2 and 3 here, and 0, 1 from this side. Okay, so if you try all combination, it will be 0, 0 and then 0, 1 and then 0, 2 and then 0, 3 and for 1 here, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2 and 1, 3. Okay. So this is your all possible combination that is possible between A and B here. Now see here, when they try to transmit at the same time, there will be a collision, no doubt. Okay, so now here A is waiting, A is not waiting, B is waiting for some time. So it means A won here. In this particular case, A is not waiting, B is waiting for 2 time units. It means again A won here. A is not waiting, but B is waiting for 3 time units. So it means again A won here. In the similar time, in this particular case, A is waiting, B is not waiting, so B won here. And you see, there is a 1-1 here, it means there is a collision. So at the same time, they are trying to transmit. Here, A is waiting for 1 unit and B is waiting for 2 units. So it means first A is able to transfer its data. So A again won here and A again won here. Okay. So if you check the probability of collision here, so 1, 2, okay. So 2 out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 cases are collision. Probability of winning A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 by 8. Okay. So probability of winning B, it is only winning 1 time out of 8 times. Okay. So if you're seeing here that the probability of winning of A of B is further reduced. Okay. So if you're seeing here, the probability of again winning of A is around 62%, around 62%, 8648, around 62%, but the probability of winning this particular, in this particular scenario is around, I think, 8, 10, just let me see, around it will be, 8, so 228 to the, so it is around 12%, okay, so 12% chance of winning of B and 62% chance of winning of E, okay. So suppose in this particular scenario, because the probability of A is more, so again it's a conditional probability. Why? Because conditional probability means that in this particular condition A has already won, okay, so A has won one time. So that is why this now becomes your conditional probability, that after winning A, what is the probability of again winning of A? Okay. So now if I again find that in this particular scenario, again A won here. Suppose A won again. That is the second time. Now you check, you will see that it is the probability of winning A is further increased. Okay. So this is the third packet of A. This is the first packet of A, B. Okay, so if there is still again a collision between these two, now the third packet is included in the collision first time, but the first packet of B is included in the collision third time. Okay, so you have to choose a number, random number between 0 to 2 raised to power 3 minus 1. So it will be 0 to 2 raised to power 3, it is 7. Okay, so 0 to 7, I think. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it is 7. 2 raised to power 3 is 8 minus 1, yeah. 0 to 7, and here it will be 0 to 1 again. If you try the combinations here, so I'll try it. It will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 combinations here, and another 8 combinations will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so now see, this is collision. This is again A is winning. This is again A is winning. A is winning. A is winning here. A is winning here. A is winning here. A is also winning. In this particular case, B won because A has to wait for 1 unit time. B does not have to wait. But in this particular, there is a collision. Now in this particular scenario, again A1, 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 A1. Okay, so if you find out the probability of collision is again, it is, I think it is occurring 2 times. So 2 times out of 16 times, probability of winning A is 13 times out of 16 times, and the probability of winning B is 1 time out of 16 times. Okay, so if you gather something from first case here, see, for the probability of collision is 50% in the first case. In the second case, it is around 1/8. It is very, very less. I think it is again around 12%. Okay, so it has reduced further, and the probability of collision in the third case has reduced even further. That is 2/16. Okay, so it is again it has again reduced way further. Okay, so Arish, I think it is 1/4 here. So it is 25%. The probability of collision first was 50%, then was 25%. Here I think it is 12%. Okay, so I think it is the probability of collision getting reduced is exponential. Okay, so every time the collisions are getting reduced. So that is the advantage here. The advantage of back off algorithm, that every step the collisions are getting reduced. Now what is the disadvantage? That every step, if one particular component, one particular opponent won here, so it is one, it has won 1 time out of 4, but if it has won here again, that it will, the chance of getting the same station won increases to increases here. So it is 62% here, and if you see here, it is even further than that. Okay, so now this particular thing is called your capture effect. Capture effect means that the probability of a station to win again and again. If suppose I'll write it, if A has won in first collision, if A has won in first collision, its winning probability will increase in the second one. Its winning probability will increase in the second one. Okay, so something is called your capture effect. Now this is the disadvantage. Now your another disadvantage can be that this particular algorithm can be only applied on two stations only. Okay, so this is a binary station, either there will be two station, it can only be applied in two stations. Okay, so it is also sometimes called binary back off algorithm. Okay, so sometimes it's also called binary back off algorithm. But the advantage here is that the collisions are decreasing exponentially. Okay, so collisions are decreasing exponentially at every try. Okay, there are some advantages, there are some disadvantages. Okay, that is why I've said that if in the first step both of the stations have equal probability of winning, in the second step it will not be. Okay, so it can happen that the other station will starve, it will never get a chance to transmit the data. Okay, so if you go towards this back of algorithm, the same procedure is written here, you can refer to it. So again, remember that the waiting time is given by here at discrete time slot, that is given by t slot. Okay, so whose length is equal to t here. Okay, so you already know this. Okay, so everything, the example is same here. I think the example is only for 2 times. I have taken 3 times here. Okay, so here the example is. Okay, the disadvantage is capture effect, that the station who keeps winning one time keep on winning, and it works only on two stations. That is the disadvantage. Now the advantage is that the collision probability decreases exponentially. Okay, so we can refer to this particular slide if you have any doubt, or I can upload this particular class. Okay, so now we have just remaining with one key concept here, that is our token passing. Okay, so I'll try to cover token passing access control method and Aloha. Though there are two methods remaining, I'll try to cover it in the next lecture. Hopefully the access control will be finished in the next lecture. We'll try to start our next topic, that is error control here. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me, or you know what, you can move on.